welcome to tonight's performance of Dancing with the Stars live. We would also like to inform you that strobe lighting will be in use.
You guys on a different level. Like literally the altitude that you guys are on like a different level. So my shirt is already open. I did try to diagnose it. Try to see, maybe I have a phobia of buttons or something. He just said vanity, that's it, that's the only diagnosis. It's vain, I'm sorry.
Give it up for my amazing partner, Alex Carlatos. And I have had the amazing pleasure of working with him all season long. I've learned a lot about him in these past 12 weeks, but I think the biggest thing I've learned is that his life has seriously changed so much. I don't think he ever would have expected to be here on this stage, right?
I'm absolutely not. I mean, I've had such a crazy journey. My life has been pretty much turned 180 degrees on its head, and pretty much nothing is the same. And by the way, I don't know how people breathe up here.
There's really? Yeah, we're just taking deep breaths right now. Well, like Alex said, his life truly has changed so much, and he's had to overcome a lot of obstacles. One of those obstacles being dealing with me and learning how to dance.
I don't know any partner that could have been as patient with me as Lindsay was, because I'm kind of a hard person to deal with sometimes. I've been kind of desensitized to some things. I mean, spending a year in Afghanistan kind of ruins your people skills a little bit, so there we go. I'm working on it here tonight with you guys, so I'm practicing still, so don't expect too much, but all right. And honestly, this show has been probably the greatest thing that's ever happened to me. I've had so much fun. It's been such a blast, and the people on the show are absolutely amazing. And so that being said, I'd like to introduce them to you. And here they are, dancing music to the film Great Gatsby.
You know what? It all started in Salt Lake City, which I thought was difficult. I moved to
Colorado Springs.
I thought that was hard. And today, oh my God.
Redwoods.
This is it.
A funny thing happened this season. We both weren't a part of it. And it's very sad indeed.
It's a very sore subject, you know? And you know why that happened? We call it Curse of the Poster.
Don't ever be on the poster, okay?
You're not gonna make the show.
Mm-hmm. We thought we'd hit the jackpot, but no.
You know, it's funny actually, I don't even remember doing that.
I don't know what happened that day, but I don't either.
Yeah, you know what, I'm always curious because it's a kind of interesting the way. Should we try?
Where are your legs? I can't even see your legs on that.
Me too.
Uh-huh.
Do you think I was on my knees or just standing?
I think you were down somewhere around here. Uh-huh, that was it.
Yeah?
Now I...
Yeah?
Somehow...
Yeah?
...had my right leg down and my left leg was all the way wrapped around here.
Magic of the Photoshop.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, that's it.
Okay, we're good.
Good job.
We try.
So moral of the story, don't put your hands up to be on the poster. Because you don't get on the show.
Well, enough about sad things. Let's talk about really exciting things. Like, for example, someone got engaged.
Yes, I did. That was an awesome moment and something that I'll never forget. So thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Keep going. We want to know more.
No more.
All right. Okay, well, you know, the thing is, I thought that when you get engaged, you get a ring, right?
Yes, you do.
Yeah? What happened?
Well, I just don't want to dance with it, you see. I just want to keep it in a little safe place where I can't get knocked around.
Well, you know, funny enough, actually, you know, the previous part for the Gatsby, you were supposed to be my wife.
Ooh.
Yeah, about that.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. That's my time to leave,
okay.
So thank you very much for this. Thank you, everybody. Goodbye.
Last time I was talking about the reason is I'm dancing because of my parents. Well, I think recently I discovered a whole different level of why I'm dancing. And that's because you can meet the ladies. Right? Yes, and you know what, I've been fortunate enough to share this stage with this amazing, stunning, beautiful women of Dancing with the Stars. And to prove that, this is the next act.
Since joining Dancing with the Stars, right? I mean, look at this. And you know how girls love to talk? Well,
you know, it's going around in the change room that you have a very big
heart. I love everyone very much and, you know, she's got a big heart.
That's exactly what I was going to say, Alan. Come on, please. Little rascal, get off stage. All right, moving right along to the smoothest gentleman we have here. Ladies, his nickname is Velvet. Now, you're all very well aware of social media these days. It gets really crazy for us, from Twitter to Instagram. I mean, you guys wouldn't believe what we get asked on a daily basis. Very personal questions. So, Artem, what is the number one thing that's been the craziest thing that a fan has ever asked you?
Well, it was a kind of funny situation, actually. I've been doing UK version of Dancing with the Stars for the past 4 years, and we're doing an arena tour. And I was getting the comments from the judges, there's lots of people in there, and all of a sudden, on the complete silence, the audience members stood up and say, "Will you marry me?" And it would be okay if the judges would continue with the comments, but they just, complete silence, looking at me, searching for response. So the best thing I could come up with is, can I think about it? So yeah.
Hang on, you're still thinking?
Absolutely.
Yeah, okay, well thank you very much for that, Artem. Okay. Hello, soon to be brother-in-law.
Speaking of brother-in-law, what are you wearing? It's like the R-rated version of the Jetsons. Like, who designed this?
Wardrobe designed this. I have nothing to do with it. Sorry.
Where's the ring?
Damn, it's not there. I'm sorry.
I've been with him for 29 years. I got no ring, nothing. 29 years.
You have to be with him for the rest of your life.
Okay. I love you, Bia.
I love you, love. Isn't he cute? Okay, Keo Motsepe, everybody. My friend. Now you have a nickname that everyone needs to know.
Do I? It's called chocolate.
Hang on, which kind?
It's called dark chocolate. No, listen. Sorry, baby. Yeah, what is this? No, I like to give women some chocolate, you know? I mean, to get to women's heart, you need to give her chocolate, so that's what I do. That's the Kia secret. Ladies.
That's enough. Thank you, Kia.
Now, guys, this is the point in the show where we do another little audience participation, as if one wasn't enough. But I feel like there are maybe three people out here that would like the opportunity to dance with some of our pros. We're looking for two ladies, and I need one gentleman.
Okay, the ladies. Ladies, I'll get you. Where you at?
Kia's picking the ladies. Go, ladies, look at Kia. Kia's gonna pick you. I need a guy. Come on, there must be one guy. No, girlfriend's like yes. He's like no. Oh, I see you. Come here, love. I like a guy who knows what he wants.
Right.
Oh, I love this.
I know, I'm good.
Hi, how are you?
It's good. I'm so excited.
You can tell. What's your name?
Andy.
Hi, Andy. We'll meet your new partner. This is Peter.
No.
Well, what's going on?
Story of my life.
Wait, what is happening here? This is
there
cute.
There we go.
Keo, what's happening?
All right.
She's shocked.
Wait.
All right, she's good. She good.
Are you happy?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
As well. Okay. He's good. All right, what's about to happen now is the screen behind me is gonna show 6 songs and 6 dance styles. And each couple has to choose 1 song and 1 dance style.
Yes.
So let's do it!
This is really going to test the ability of our pros, because obviously they've not met anybody before and they have to dance for you guys on the spot. So
alright, couple number one. What's your name?
Danica.
Hi, Danica.
Me and Danica are trying to figure things out right now.
Alright, okay, we have 4 hours.
Hey Val, this is your second partner called Danica.
Give us a second.
All right. 4 hours still? 4 hours still? All right. Are you guys ready? No. How you guys doing tonight? Woo! There we go. And another 4 hours. Yep.
Hello.
That's happening.
Yeah. Let's do it. All
right, Amy, you want to take over? All right. Are you ready?
Or we could do a crazy little thing called love. That's a great one.
She's like, no.
Danica, you don't look happy. She's shaking her head.
Okay, fine. Whose child is this? Can I ask
you? Wait.
Mom, she's a strong, independent woman, that's for sure.
Wait.
Danica, I mean, this isn't going to be the first time I get on my knees in front of a woman. But, which song would you like to dance to?
None.
All right, Kyo.
All
right, you guys take a second.
Why don't right. you? Wait, Danica. What if your partner picks for you?
I wouldn't like it.
Wouldn't like it? Okay.
I did good.
I don't really know what to do.
I did very good. Yeah? Well done, Kyo.
We're gonna do Moon River Waltz just because she's a classy lady and we're gonna take it slow.
Turn that frown upside down, little lady. No? Okay. I'm gonna move on now. Okay.
Alright. Couple number two, what's your name?
Sandra.
And Sandra, what'd you like to dance to?
I'm mad at mom.
I don't know. I want a fast one.
Eight more hours. Well done, Kyo. You did very good today.
Hips are
live. Hips are live. Wow.
Hips don't lie.
Okay, Emma.
Okay. What's your name?
I'm Andy.
Andy, this is your partner, Peter.
Hi, Peter.
Now, I'm sure you had a chance to look at the screen.
We have. We're going to do the swing.
You're gonna do swing to Crazy Thing or Not. I love that. Okay, decisive. Awesome. Right, in order to do this, we need judges. So I'm gonna elect myself.
Kyo.
Kyo's gonna be our second judge, and we're gonna welcome Miss
Lindsay
Arnold. Hello, everybody. Now, I'm a bit dubious about this, but couple number one, Miss Danica and you have chosen the waltz.
We're actually gonna go last, if you don't mind. We're still working some things out.
It's gonna be good.
Okay, couple number three. Okay, so couple number one. Couple number two, Artem, you're up next. My darling, you have picked Hips Don't Lie. So what are we looking forward to, Sam?
What was that, Artem?
They don't wanna go first.
You can't go first. Okay. What if you go second? Are you happy with that? Okay, Andy, you're up, man. You're up.
Yes.
You got it. You're dancing the swing to Crazy Little Thing Called Love. Lindsay, what are we looking for?
I just want you to have fun. I mean, you're the only one who's going first, so you got that going for you. Take it away.
The music, please. Are we ready?
They ready.
Okay, cool.
They ready.
So we're dancing the samba. What are we looking for, Linz?
I want you to have fun, girl. You got this.
Okay.
You got it.
Music, please. Woo! Lindsay's gonna tell you to have fun, right?
Just dance. That's all we want, you know? We just want you to dance and kill it.
Okay, princess.
Shaking those hips.
Yeah.
But do you think Artem's cute?
Sure.
Yeah, we got a sure. That's pretty good. Amazing. Amazing. Kyo.
I don't know what to do with myself right now. That's all good. How's Dancing with Peter? I mean, she's engaged.
It was okay.
We have a tough crowd.
Okay, just okay.
Awesome. It was amazing. That was awesome. Okay. Give it up for everyone, guys.
Give it up for these amazing dancers! Woo! Really, thank you.
Thank you for flying DWTS Airways. We welcome our Mirabol Million Dollar Medallion members. If the person next to you hyperventilates at the sight of Artem's abdominals, please ring the dance attendant call button and we will batchikata right to you. For those of you in the first two rows, you are in the vow sweat zone. Ladies, you're welcome. We have six exits. Stage left, stage right, downstage, upstage, and... Oh, well, I guess that's it. Ladies and gentlemen, the captain has turned on the fasten your dance belt sign. If you haven't already done so, please sit down, buckle up, and enjoy the ride. Dance attendants, please prepare for takeoff.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Welcome to Havana.
I feel that you're
friends, but with the holidays coming up, I've been stressing about what to get all my family and friends for Christmas. I mean, especially I've been stressing about what I'm gonna get Alec for Christmas. But I think I have found the perfect present. So I'm gonna have him come out and I'll tell him, Alec. Alec. He's not listening to me. Maybe he'll listen to you guys. Come on, call him out. There he is. I was just talking about you.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, I was. I think I figured out what I'm gonna give you for Christmas. Are you ready?
Is it a hoverboard?
No, it's not. I and we all know that you had a serious crush on one of the professional dancers this season. Does anybody know who that is? Are they correct?
Yeah, a little bit.
Just a little. Just a tiny, tiny crush. Well, I know you had so much fun with her on Switch Up Week, so I thought I would let you dance your rumble one more time for everybody. What do you think?
Best partner ever right here.
Merry Christmas, Alec. Amazing. I'm Jenna.
I'm Brittany.
I'm Ellen. How's everyone doing today? Yay! You know, I don't know if you guys know this, we're on the road for 8.5 weeks, which puts a toll on our body. But we get a lot of questions from all of you guys, and one of the questions happens to be, how do we live in a small bus?
I will tell you one thing, you definitely do not want to sleep next to Keo or Val because they are the loudest snorers on the tour.
It's true. It's very true.
Sorry, guys.
You definitely don't want to sleep anywhere near Jenna's suitcase because she packed her whole closet with her.
My suitcase looks like it threw up clothes everywhere. It's fine. Well, yeah. Well, we can't forget about Artem's protein shakes. I mean, that man, his body, though.
I'm going to stop you right now because, Artem, I got your back. It takes a lot to take care of that.
Stop. Just stop. No, ladies, come on.
Artem, I got you.
Anyways, aside from Alan's abs, us girls like to stop by and explore the towns we're in each and every day. You know, stop by the mall, hit up the shops.
Shop?
What do you like to do, Alan?
Us guys like to work out.
That's about it.
That's about it for the day. No, I'm just joking. Took a killer nap today.
So embarrassing. No, to be honest, guys, we have a blast on tour. It's some of our favorite moments and memories that we shared together. Put your shirt, oh my goodness. But we do have some rules. Number one, throw away your trash on the bus. Boys. Two, bunk area is quiet time.
Girls, yeah. They like to gossip.
We do. And three, do not be late to bus call. We will leave you.
Alan.
It was once.
It was the first city on our tour. It's okay, Alan. No, all jokes aside, we are all one big happy family and we do love each other. And at the end of the day, we just like to throw in some popcorn, put on a movie, and just hang out.
I'm gonna make you an offer you can't refuse. Godfather happens to be my favorite movie and this is embarrassing.
And I love anything to do with James Bond. Please enjoy the cinema section.
So funny how time flies, you know. Next season is gonna be my 10th season on the show. Oh man, I went from the youngest sibling to the old fart in the blink of an eye. Man, before every show, we get together and we say a little prayer. And one of the things we mention is to come out and dance with gratitude. I believe that when you do everything with gratitude, anything you do with gratitude is bound to be successful. It's bound to attract love, attract happiness, joy. And so when we come out here, there's a great deal of gratitude. Not only to God or whatever you believe in for giving us this talent and this opportunity, also to our parents and loved ones that stood us for so many years. I don't know how many of you are related to artists or dancers. It's a very difficult life. You know, every time we have a family gathering, you gotta be the center of attention. You gotta like dance or sing or do something. But the life of an artist is a pretty difficult one. And for us to be on the stage tonight is literally a dream come true. I know it sounds cliche, but it truly is. Not in a million years that I think I was gonna end up here. And I don't think any of us thought so. So we all come from many different backgrounds. We all have very, very specific, very interesting stories. And tonight we really wanna share them with you. So please enjoy. These are the stories of your Dancing with the Stars cast.
The universal deed of Mother Nature. The seamless synchronicity of the sun and the moon, night into day. The rhythm of the drum that only Mama Africa can make. This moves me. What moves me? The rhythm I find when I breathe this all in. And the infinite power I feel when I exhale this love. This is when I'm at one with the universe, in touch with God.
Dance has been like a glowing ember. I wasn't born with it. It wasn't given to me. I found it. And I nurtured it. It grew inside of me like wildfire. Every moment, every decision, every path has led me back to the dance floor.
There is a sense of invincibility to roam my soul. Nothing in the world matters to me when I'm on the dance floor. Doing what I love, doing what feels right. The music drives me. The lights push me further. And the cheers take me on a trip to my very own euphoria.
For me, it's like my first language. It's very personal to each individual, and therefore, it's mine. It's me. It's who I am. It's mine. It's me. It's who I am.
So if you ask me what moves me and makes me want to wake up every morning, it's going to the studio, listening to the music, creating the story, dancing the dance that makes you feel good. That's what makes you want to do it again. And that's what moves me every day.
To be really honest, being so sensitive has been a problem for me. I'm constantly affected by things, and I found myself trying to bury that because others around me did. I wanted to mute it and appear untouched, but there's nothing more beautiful than being truly affected. I can't be judged for wearing my heart on the outside, where it's always fighting to be anyway.
Believing in ourselves is one of the hardest things to do in a world where everyone is compared to an image of what is perfect. No one is perfect, and not one person in this world is identical to another. We all look, speak, feel, and move differently. Dance has taught me to embrace that. It's taught me to love my imperfections and believe in myself.
All mankind is divided into three classes. Those that are immovable, those that are movable, and those that move. isn't you. The real you is what is within you. What is behind your joy or melancholy? What gives you reasons to dream? To stay inspired, you have to know what moves you. Passion, angst, fear, struggle, compromise, all of life's challenges. They drive me to expand my limits through dance. Love another and love yourself. Love moves me. When I was younger, and times were hard at home, I would put on my headphones and listen to music from Dirty Dancing. It would take me to another world. It was my escape from the things that hurt me. As far back as I can remember, dance and music have been a part of me. As an adult, it's been my therapy and my release. It's kept me healthy. It's helped me heal from the hard times, and it's always shown me I can do anything if I just try. I can honestly say that dance has saved my life.
It's been roughly 2 decades now, 20 years that I've been dancing. I don't remember why I started dancing. I guess I have my parents to thank for that horrible decision. That and sarcasm, two things that got me into plenty of trouble in my life. When I was a kid, I didn't know what I wanted to be when I grew up. I just wanted to be successful. Not so much for the money or the fame, but for the opportunity to make my family proud. In return on their lifelong support, countless sacrifices they made in order for me to have a chance to thrive and flourish. Driven by a burning desire to provide and inspire, I dance because it is my shot at the American dream. I guess that makes me the cliche immigrant story, huh? The only difference is I made my dream a reality on the parquet floors of a rusty old ballroom dance studio.
What's going on, us? And you probably have no idea who I am. A few weeks ago, I was just on vacation on a train, of all places, and...
Terror takedown. California men save a train full of people from a terrorist.
A gunman opened fire on a high-speed train.
The unarmed and off-duty servicemen showed great bravery.
Spencer, Alan, and Anthony are truly heroes.
This whole thing is just absolutely crazy.
Hey, guys.
Hello, sir.
Well, I don't like a class reunion. We just have a beer. We don't, like, tackle terrorists.
I've never danced. Like, ever.
Tell me what you think the Foxtrot is.
I have no idea, but I feel like I am representing Spencer and Anthony. I just really hope I do them proud.
We're dancing in frame, which that means we're dancing like this.
Oh.
I'm Lindsay Arnold, and this is my second season as a pro. When I first found out that Alec was my partner, I was so incredibly honored.
You're gonna be fine, I promise.
He really has surprised me. I mean, his work ethic is amazing, and he takes notes really well.
You remember that whole thing? That was good. Did you practice last night?
Oh.
Yeah, you did.
Since the train, just about everything in my life has changed. But at the same time, I'm just a guy. I never realized this would happen to me, and now that it actually is, I'm just like trying to soak it all in.
That was super smooth.
Ooh, calm me down.
Jersey boy, this jacket. I lived in Jersey for a while. Really? It's not gonna help you. You guys having a good night, man? What a great night, huh? Alexa. Alexa, Allie, Maddie. Allie, Maddie, Maddie, no? What is it? Greece, I was way off. Greece, I know we met at the meet and greet, and I kept, you know, made you a promise, come on. Reese, you had a good time? Okay. Well, we match. Did you plan this?
Dude, Dan's at my dance class.
Yeah, I mean, do you take dance?
Yeah.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite style?
Ballet.
Ballet, wow. Show me a plie. Hey, nice. That was good. You're gonna be on Dancing with the Stars one day, you know that? Yeah. That's what I said. I said the same thing, holy.
Five,
I was laughing the same exact way. Well, anyway, listen, unfortunately our show is over. Almost. We still got a couple of numbers for you. But I wanted to say thank you. This is the last time I get to talk to you guys. So thank you so much for coming out. Give yourselves a round of applause. You know, this is what it's about, right here. I don't think a blessing is truly realized until it's passed forward. So we all on this stage, we're truly blessed to be here tonight. And we thank you for being here with us. And this is how we express our gratitude. So I hope you guys enjoyed your night with us, and tune in March 21st, season 22, I can't believe it. But we're gonna do it again. So thank you so much, and keep your hands clapping for your Dancing with the Stars.